Now, let me read verse 7. And they said, every one to his fellow, come and let us cast lots, that we may know for whose cause this evil is upon us. So they cast lots, and the lot fell upon Jonah. Now, I've already had several letters in on the book of Jonah, and actually a couple that disagree with me very severely. They apparently have read my book, and they know what I'm going to say a little later. And one of them feels like that I approve of this matter of casting lots, of gambling. Well, I hope the individual that feels that way will listen to me very carefully at this time, because I think gambling is an awful curse. And I think today that that method that's being used to raise taxes in our nation will ultimately corrupt our people and corrupt the nation. And in the end, why, it will be more destructive than it could possibly be helpful. Now, somebody else is going to say, as this person, why, this was a superstitious thing that they were doing, to cast lots to see this evil has come upon us. And they cast lots and it fell on Jonah. Well, apparently God was in that and used that, but that doesn't mean that God approved that at all. I do not believe that Samuel was called back from the dead. I don't believe that old witch could do it. I don't think Satan himself could have done it. Only God can raise up the dead. Only God has the power over death and of the grave. Remember, the Lord Jesus said he had the keys there, and I don't think he's ever turned them over to Satan. Now, what we have here is the fact that they cast lots, and can God use that? Well, may I give you an experience I had in my first pastorate. The very wonderful pastor that I followed there, he'd so prepared the way for me, he told me about a family that had gone into spiritualism. And I'm not going to develop that particular feature today, but it was marvelous how God used that to bring these people back to themselves. But also, he told me about another family where the little girl was attending the church, but he had not been able to reach the father at all, the head of the house. The wife attended, and she was a believer. The little girl was a beautiful little red-headed girl. And so at Christmas time, he came to church. And so I, you know, whispered to several people to be friendly with him, and we all shook hands with him, and his criticism was that we overdid it, that we were too friendly. And so at Easter time, he came back to the church, and I told the folk, I said, he doesn't want us to shake hands with him, be friendly. So we didn't. I did at the door, but just barely did. And he said his criticism of the church was we were too cold. Now, that was a fellow you couldn't please at all. I went to visit him, and he just practically ordered me out of the house. He didn't want me to talk to him about the Lord. Well, it was about, I suppose, 6 months after that, that I was getting ready for bed. In fact, I'd already put on my pajamas, and the doorbell rang, and I went to the door, and there stood this man, and he had a frightened look on his face. He said, could I talk with you? And I said, yes. And he said, I want to tell you the background. Now, he ran a dry cleaning place. He had a woman that worked for him at the desk, the cashier. And so she said to him one morning, she said, you know, I went to a fortune teller last night. And the fortune teller told me that I'm going to die suddenly. And both of them laughed about it. And then she said, and the fortune teller said that the man I'm working for, my employer, he's going to die suddenly. And they laughed again because they thought that was preposterous and ridiculous. But about 2 days after that, that woman, she stepped off of the streetcar. That is back in the days of the streetcars. And she was hit by a car that didn't stop. And she was killed almost instantly. Well, I want to tell you, when that man found that out, he really became excited. And that very night is when he came and knocked on the door. He said, I must be next. And I said to him, I said, well, I think that I can relieve your fear there. I said that the fortune teller had nothing in the world to do with it and had no prior knowledge. That's just one of those strange circumstances of life. We call it a coincidence, and I think that's what it was. And I don't think it means you'll die. He says, well, I want to be prepared. He said, would you explain to me the plan of salvation? And I got a piece of wrapping paper, and I got down on the floor in my pajamas, and I took a piece of crayon, and I outlined the plan of salvation there for him, and how God had sent Christ in the world to die for our sin. And that man was ready that night. He accepted Christ as his Savior. And you know, I always, after that, have thought that the devil pushed that fellow a little too far because he was responsible for the man getting saved. And very frankly, God can use things like that. He does. He says he'll make the wrath of man to praise him, and he can make the superstition of man. Now, these were superstitious fellows. God is going to use that. And they cast lots. Lot falls on Jonah. The X marks the spot where he stands.